write down, it is a delocalization of resonance, write down, it is a delocalization of pi electrons or lone pair. It is the delocalization of pi electrons or lone pair. Next line. It is the method of representation of one molecule or ion into more than one structural unit in which the position of pi electrons or lone pair in which the position of pi electrons or lone pair is different. Okay, position of pi electrons or lone pair is different. So resonance, in a single line, you can say it is delocalization of pi electrons or lone pair. For example, CH3 C double bond O, O minus, negative charge. Okay, and minus means what? We have three lone pairs on this oxygen atom. Okay. In this oxygen atom, we have two lone pairs present. Okay? So the resonating structure of this ion is separated by this arrow, double headed arrow. Okay, this arrow we use to represent the RS, resonating structure. Correct? Now, when you draw the resonating structure of this, this lone pair forms a bond pair of electrons, and this pi electron shifts onto this oxygen atom. Okay? And it gives what? CH3 C single bond O negative charge and double bond. This is the resonating structure. Okay. Another resonating structure, we can take the example of benzene. Also the resonating structure, because the two molecules are different. We have single bond between first and second carbon and double bond here, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, this is the resonance. Now, like I said, all resonating structure or the different representation that we have, all these different representations are called as resonating structures or canonical structures, resonating structures, resonating structures, canonical structures, structures, or we also call it as contributors. Resonating, canonical or contributor. Okay, resonating structure will take the reference of RS right now, because this will use most often in this section. RS means resonating structure. Canonical structure, resonating structure, same thing. Contributors means also the same thing, because all these RS contributes into the real structure. We know all these resonating structures are what? These are imaginary structures. These are not real structures. Imaginary structures, not real. The real structure is the combination of all these resonating structures, okay? And that we call it as resonating, resonance hybrid or resonating hybrid, okay? So resonating hybrid or the resonance hybrid for this structure is this one. Benzene ring, and this pi electron is delocalized over the entire ring. This is the real structure, hybrid and radial structure. Resonance hybrid or radial structure. For this, the resonance hybrid is what? CH3COO and the pi electron delocalized from this oxygen to this oxygen. Delta negative. This is the hybrid or radial structure. All these things we have discussed already, right? In chemical formulas. Now the next question is, in which of the molecule the resonance is possible? When you draw the resonating structure, first of all you should understand that whether the resonance is possible or not. Okay? So for that we have certain conditions. That condition must be satisfied by the molecule or ion, then only resonance is possible. So what are those conditions? Okay, that we should understand. Different types of conditions, we have different types of conjugated system. We have in all these conjugated system, the resonance is possible. The first condition, I'll just tell you one by one. Okay, don't write now, I'll just dictate it. The first condition is molecule must be planar. Planar molecule, why it is required? Because delocalization means what? It is the shifting of electron pair, right? This electron pair, maybe it is a pi electron or lone pair, okay? So benzene ka example if you take, so this benzene has a p orbital here. This also has a p orbital. Here also we have a p orbital. Okay, and all these orbitals are parallel. Okay, it is parallel, and that's why the shifting of electron pair is possible. If it is not parallel, not planar, then one p orbital like this, another one like this. So overlap is not possible. When p orbital faces each other, then only overlap is possible in pi bond form. That's why planar molecule is required for this. Okay? So if I draw this structure, you see this structure, if you rotate this structure this way, it means when these two p orbital overlaps, it forms a pi bond. Right? We'll get a pi bond here. When these two overlaps, we'll get a pi bond here. And when these two overlaps, we'll get a pi bond here. Correct? So if I say these two are overlapping, so why not these two orbital can overlap? These two may also overlap, right? Because both are parallel. So we can have overlapping of this two, this two, this two, this two, this two. All overlap is possible. That's why this pi electron continuously shift from one point to another. And this delocalization of electron is nothing but transition. Okay. The first condition is planar molecule, why it is required? Because then only the orbitals will be facing each other, and then only shifting of pi electron is possible. Got it? Okay?
So this way that the electron keeps moving in a circle, right?
Yes.
But when it's next to one of the C molecules, won't the attraction with the nucleus be strong, so it'll just stay there?
No, not possible. Attraction of nucleus is everywhere, wherever the pi electron we have. Attraction will be same at every point. Because of this delocalization of electron, it gains stability.
That's right. Right in the center of two C atoms, the force will be weak, right?
That will attract this sigma electrons, not pi electrons. Sigma electrons will attract, but that is also that much attraction is not possible because both carbon atom has same electronic configuration. Same electronegativity. So that won't attract the sigma electrons also. But whatever attraction is there, it is there for all the electrons. But that won't affect the shifting of electrons into different orbitals. Got it? Okay. So first of all, when you solve questions in organic chemistry, you should have this idea that in the given molecule, whether the resonance is possible. Okay. So how do we know that the resonance is possible? For that, we have certain conditions. One, I have told you that molecule must be planar, because in planar molecule only, the orbital will be parallel to each other, and then shifting of electron possible. Right. So condition, write down condition. Condition and characteristics of resonance. Condition and characteristics of resonance and resonating structures. See, one more thing I'll tell you. I said that this resonating structure RS are contributors. Okay? Why these are contributors? Because this molecule also contributes into the real structure, and this also contributes into the real structure. right? I mean, some property, this hybrid structure will have the property from this molecule and this molecule, both. I mean, the hybrid molecule takes property, or the property of hybrid molecule will be because of its all resonating structure, okay? Now, if these two, both RS, are equally stable, right? There are two possibilities. One is what, if only two RS is possible, for example, this one, right? So these two can contribute equally into the ideal structure. This is one possibility. Another possibility is what? One contributes more than the other, right? So in these two cases, we have two types of contributors also. One is equal contributor, another one is unequal contributors, correct? Yes. Equal contributors are those RS which contributes equally into the ideal structure, right? Means half properties ka half properties, equal contributors, correct?
So how will they not be equal contributors?
I'm not saying they are not.
No, but then you're saying in some cases there is no contributors.
I will discuss that. We cannot finish resonance in 5 minutes. I'm just giving an idea what are possibility we can have.
So you know that like if you have equal contributors, you'll have half property from here and half property from that one. What do you mean by half property?
Half property means they contribute equally. Suppose if this structure has 10 properties, you talk about melting point, you talk about bond order, you talk about bond strength, bond length, okay? So it has certain number of properties we can define. What is the bond length of this C1C2 carbon? Bond order of C1C2 carbon, it is 2, right? What is the bond order of this C1C2 carbon? 1. So this wants that the bond order in real estate should be 1, C1C2, but this wants the bond stress should be 2. So the actual bond structure 1.5, that's what it means. It will be in between, the average of the two, right? In case of equal contributors. But when the contribution is not equal, suppose now I'm assuming these two are unequal contributors, right? Then which one will contribute more? That depends upon the stability of the contributors, correct? If this one is more stable, then this structure wants that the bond order of C1C2 carbon should be 2, right? And this wants what? 1. But since it is more stable, so we can say the bond order of C1C2 carbon should be closer to 2. Because it is more stable, it contributes more. So we can say that the bond order of C1C2 carbon will be in the range of 1.5 to 2. Exact calculation of bond order is not possible in case of unequal contributors. Equal may we can take average, but unequal contributors, we cannot find out the exact bond order of the bond, right? Any bond. But we can give you a range, we can write a range of it, that, right? Like in this case, if this one is more stable, then obviously the bond order should be 1.5 to 2, we can say. 1 to 1.5 will be there if this one is more stable. Understood? So these are the application of resonance. With resonance, what we all things we can conclude, the first application is to find out the bond order of the bond in a molecule, okay? And if you have the idea of bond order, we can find out what? Bond strength, we can find out bond length, because you know bond order and bond strength are directly proportional. Bond order and bond length are inversely proportional. So all these ideas we can have. So one by one we'll see that, but first of all you write down the condition and characteristics of resonance. The first condition is the molecule must be planar. The position of atoms, next one, the position of atoms and the position of atoms and sigma electrons are fixed. Position of atoms and sigma electrons are fixed. Sigma electron does not take part in resonance. It is always pi electrons or lone pairs. But in I effect, we have sigma electrons, right? The sigma electron does not take part in resonance, right? Next point to write down, it is independent of distance. It is independent of distance. Like I effect it depends upon distance, right? It is independent of distance. In resonance, next one. In resonance, pi electrons and lone pair are interconvertible. Lone pair can form pi bond, and pi electrons can convert into lone pairs. All RS, all RS are separated by, all RS are separated by this double headed arrow, this one, double headed arrow, right? All RS are separated by double headed arrow, this double headed arrow. Write down, resonating structure RS does not explain all the properties of the molecule or ion. The resonating structure does not explain all the properties of molecule or ion. All resonating structures are imaginary or hypothetical structures. These are not real structures. All resonating structures are imaginary or hypothetical structures. Okay? For a molecule to show resonance, molecule or ion to show resonance, it must be conjugated. It must be conjugated. The system must be conjugated. Okay? If conjugated system is there, a system means molecule or ion.
So what do you mean by conjugated?
Conjugated will discuss. Okay, so it must be conjugated and planar. That's the two conditions we have to show resonance. Now what is a conjugated system? What is
in this CH3CO minus, is it possible for both the O's to have double bond and C to have one minus charge?
No, it's not possible.
But C can show one minus
charge. But C won't be stable.
So isn't it because of formal charge that won't happen? It will be unstable because of formal charge.
Because of charge it is unstable. Carbon cannot have five bonds.
So carbon has three bonds, right?
Four.
No, sir, but we can have three bonds and a one plus two.
But we'll talk about stability, right? So neutral carbon is more stable than charge, whether it's negative or positive. Okay? Now what is a conjugated system? This is the most important one. If you want to know whether the resonance is possible or not, the system must be conjugated. Molecular ions must be conjugated. The first type of conjugated, there are five or six different types of conjugated system we have. Five or six different type of conjugated system. We'll see one by one all of them, right? The first type is, we'll have a lone pair present on the first atom, right? We'll take first one this. We'll have a pi bond, then sigma bond, and then we'll have a vacant orbital. Write down this way. Pi, sigma, vacant orbital. Okay? This is vacant orbital. Okay? The example of this you see. Suppose we have CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH2 positive charge. Okay? Positive charge means what? It's one orbital is vacant because it has the electron is not present on the carbon atom. Right? One electron is lost, right? So this positive charge, you can also write this, or when you write this sigma, pi sigma positive charge, that is also the same type of conjugated system. Both are same, this one or this one. Means when you write positive charge, it means one orbital is what? One orbital is vacant, that's what it means. Okay, so pi sigma positive charge is first type of conjugated system. Now when you draw the orbital diagram of this, which is not required, so I won't draw it always, just the first one, I'll just make you understand this with orbital diagram. This pi orbital is vacant, right? Here we have a p orbital and here we have a p orbital. Now you see all the p orbitals are parallel, right? And this forms lateral overlapping, it forms pi bond. Right? So what happens if this, since the orbital is vacant, so it can take the two electron into this orbital. This orbital can also overlap. Right?
Only two resonates.
CH2. So this gives you the another resonating structure, which is CH2, CH2, and this orbital will be what? Empty and heaven what? Okay, so this is the resonating structure. Pi means double bond, the overlap is double bond.
So that structure is also an example of type 1, right?
No, not type 1.
No?
You have negative, pi sigma negative. So pi sigma lone pair.
No, sir, but that double bond oxygen has a empty.
Where? Yeah, man. This one.
Double bond oxygen.
This one. Pi, sigma, here we don't have positive charge. Do we have? Here we don't have positive charge.
So would you say that that O has a, like a vacant orbital because it can accommodate?
No, 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 it's not. It has one lone pair present. Extra electron. Vacant orbital means it is electron deficient. Vacant orbital means what? That it has lost its electron. Right? So this has negative charge means it has extra electron present.
So does it always mean that it has to be positive? Because what about if it's a vacant?
No, it's not always.
Yeah.
It's not always because there are some molecules which are electron deficient, neutral but electron deficient. That example, that's what I have given this. Right? This one is the better one. This also is the same thing, but this representation is better. We'll do that example first. Understood this one? So when you draw the resonating structure of this, simply what you do, this pi electron shift over here, and it gives CH2 positive charge, CH double bond, CH. This is the RS of this. Orbital diagram is not required, okay? Directly you can shift electron and write. Okay. Can you draw the resonating structure in this? Check also if whether resonance is possible or not. No, no, I have given you these ions, molecules. You have to write down the RS of this, if it is possible. If it is possible. See, first of all, how do we check? The system must be conjugated, planarly conjugated. So at least you see, these three carbon, 1, 2 and 3, these carbons are sp2 hybridized. Okay, planar. And it is pi, sigma and vacant orbital. On this positive charge means vacant orbital on the carbon atom. Right? Pi, sigma, positive charge, type 1 conjugation. So when you draw the resonating structure, this pi electron comes over here and the RS will be. We have a pi bond here and positive charge. Okay?
So that can shift to all 6 pairs, right?
No.
3 at
this side we don't have a resonance.
So
it's not conjugated. From here to here, delocalization is possible.
Yeah.
This part is not involved because all are sp3 hybridized carbon. This side we do not have conjugation. See? Okay? So if you draw the hybrid of this, the real structure will be like this. From this carbon to this carbon, the pi electron delocalizes. Delta positive on this carbon and delta positive on this carbon. This is the hybrid of this. Because this part is not involved in resonance. Now the RS on this is what? 3 R is possible. Is it clear?
So how is this one do the business type
now? Presence hybrid. Pi electron is delocalized. See, the first structure we have pi electron here. Second, we have pi electron here. We have pi electron here also, and here also. Positive charge, we have this carbon, this carbon, this carbon. So delta positive, delta positive.
Okay. Yeah, so it has zero in its value.
Is this a conjugated system? Last one.
So it does have a vacant orbital.
No.
Is this a conjugated system?
Yeah. But boron is
here.
No.
Huh?
No. No.
Boron
no.
Is
No.
Boron has one vacant orbital. Boron has a vacant orbital. When there's 3 bond, that's why it is electron deficient. It can accept pair of electron and behaves as the Lewis acid. Okay. You can draw this. How many electrons boron has? 5? Right? So 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, excited state mein kya hoga? 2s1, 2p2. So diagram of 2s1 will be this. 1, 2 and 3, one vacant orbital we have. 3 bond, 1 electron pair makes a bond with this and 2 hydrogen atom overlap. So one orbital vacant pair. So that's why when you write pi sigma positive charge, it is not always true. But when you write pi sigma vacant p, okay, vacant orbital, in this case it is possible. Correct? So iska, what will be the resonating structure? This comes over here. And RS will be CH2 positive charge. CH double bond BH. Is it right?
Yeah.
Is it right?
Yeah.
It's not. Because we'll have one negative charge here. See, the RS, all RS will have same charge. A neutral, the molecule will be neutral. Whatever structure you are drawing, resonating structure, that must be neutral. This is a neutral molecule, right? So this cannot be the charged one. Because boron takes extra electron, so must have one negative charge. It loses electron, positive charge on it. All these ions you see, one positive charge here, here also one positive charge. This is what the same thing. Here we have one positive charge, one positive charge. One positive charge, one positive charge, one positive charge. So charge must be same in all RS. If you are not getting same charge, it means you must have done something wrong.
So is this a different type, sir? Because this has
No. The pi sigma vacant p. Same time.
So, but minus also?
Minus because of it gets extra electron. That's why we have a negative charge. See, the conjugation is this. Pi sigma vacant p. That's what the question given. Pi sigma vacant p is type 1. Is it clear? One more question you see. How many RS possible?
Which one? What's
that?
I mean,
So three. What is what when this comes on this carbon atom? Further, you see, this is also in conjugation. This comes over here. There's no further resonance possible.
So we call this as three.
Three. The given one also is RS. That also will include. Because when resonance is possible, so we always give resonating stress. Real hybrid we don't draw.
So there are only two for this.
No, the given one we also count.
It's a total three.
Total three. Got it? Okay. Now the second type you write down. Second type of conjugated system, type 2. We'll have pi sigma and lone pair. Pi sigma and lone pair. Example. First one. CH2. Double bond CH. Single bond CH2. Negative. Okay. This comes over here. And this goes. RS of this is CH2 lone pair negative CH double bond CH2. Okay? Nothing you'll get. So continuously push so much when you have. After some time you'll realize, okay, kuch nahi aa raha hai. If you want to talk, we don't do GOC then. Syllabus mein ye nahi hai, ye nahi hai book. Okay.
What's that round thing?
The oxygen. This is also round, by the way. I said this is also round. Possible resonance in second one?
Because oxygen has two lone pairs.
Two lone pairs. So it satisfies this condition, right? Pi, sigma and lone pair. So one lone pair takes part in resonance. Only one. Don't need involve in resonance. Because then oxygen becomes highly unstable. Oxygen, one positive charge. See, when you draw the resonating structure, this comes over here and this pi electron shift onto this carbon. So its RS is what? A double bond, lone pair, negative charge and positive charge. Okay, so this oxygen is highly unstable. We can draw the resonating structure, but oxygen is highly unstable. One more lone pair on this oxygen we have, but this won't take part in resonance further. Okay, because O positive charge is already unstable. It is electron deficient now, so it holds that lone pair of electron very firmly, so that further the tendency to lose electron is very less. Okay, this any compound or element which is present in the ring which has more than one lone pair, so only one lone pair takes part in resonance. This property we'll use later on, okay, when we do the aromaticity, we'll discuss over there also. In this, do we have resonance possible? How many resonating structure you'll get? Only one.
No, like a whole ring, you'll draw the ring and come back.
Draw the structures, resonating structure. Tell me how many RS possible.
So that'll be like
only this and one more.
No,
huh?
It can the lone pair can go around the
road.
It's a, in the second one, even if the second group then could take part in the reaction, could you get any more resonating structures?
No.
No, no.
That won't take part.
No, but if it could you get more structures?
If you want to draw, if conjugation is there, then you can draw.
But here there isn't, right?
It's not there.
So what will be the thing, the third one or the lone pair?
How many RS you are getting?
I didn't get it. I got only one. Right?
Why?
I got one lone.
First one is this. Is this right? Okay. Further you see, this is also in resonance, this part. Conjugation. I'll draw this side. Now this is also in resonance, sorry, in conjugation. So this comes over here, and this pi electron shift up to this oxygen. Total 5 RS possible. Is it 5 or 6? 6 RS possible. 2 and plus 4, 6.
So shouldn't the lone pair be on the...
Which are 6 possible?
So the last one is the same thing as the other.
No, it's not same.
No, no, no. Double bond, yes, sir. Yes.
Double bond, we have this side.
Double bond, yes, sir.
Where?
The
dog.
This comes over here.
Where? I'm giving me 4 stars.
Draw 2 more then. You get 6.
So after you shifted it towards that side, but it didn't shift.
Where?
So from the second one to the third one, you shifted that double bond.
See, electron always shift.
Okay, so what does the double bond here looks
like? This comes over here.
Okay.
And this pi electron under this carbonate.
That
carbonate. This carbonate is negatively charged. Now again it comes over here, it's pi electron. This oxygen. Okay. Last one, fourth one. How many RS possible?
What's the difference between the second one of that and the first one there?
What? No, it's the, oh, it's the same thing, no?
Yeah.
5.
Oh, yeah. So 5 possible.
Yeah.
So this one I have drawn here. This one I have drawn here. So this is one only. So 5 RS possible. 5 RS. Okay. See, on the ring, the negative charge is coming on alternate carbon, if you see. What is this position on the ring? If you have a benzene ring like this, what is this position? You know these two position? These two are ortho position.
Yeah, ortho. And then
this is ortho. This is also ortho. We have two ortho position. We have one para position. And two meta position.
So it can't come to meta.
Yeah, that's what. So one thing is very important. In this position we call it ortho, para and meta position in benzene ring. Okay? So when you have OH present on the ring, molecule is this, and any electrophile reacts with this ring, the reaction of an electrophile and phenol, OH on the ring is phenol, okay? That electrophile is what? Electrophile is positively charged, electron deficient species. So chances for this electrophile to attach, it will be at ortho or para position. Why? Because we are getting negative charge or more electron density at ortho and para position.
Oh, because of resonance? Yes.
Resonance, we are getting negative charge on ortho and para position. That's why E plus will attach at ortho and para position. Both product you'll get. One will be major, other one will be minor. Okay, that we'll discuss later.
So but will the major be ortho?
Depends. Because
there are two orthos, not para.
Correct. But sometimes what happens, we'll have a hydrogen bonding here. So in that case, ortho is more stiff. In general, here we have a steric hindrance. That makes the para ortho position less stable. So para is more stable in that case. So that depends. I'm not talking about which one is major or minor. But you'll get ortho and para substituted product, not meta substituted product. Got it?
What
ortho? Ortho is this solution.
So
yes.
This
two positions.
Oh, okay, those two.
Para means so any group is attached here. So these two positions are ortho position. These two positions are meta position. And this one is para. So we have two ortho, two meta, and one para position in a way. Correct? One more thing I'll tell you which is not required here. All electron releasing group. See, OH group is attached on the ring. Correct? And OH group, you see, it is releasing electron. Correct? It is releasing electron to the ring. So all electron releasing group are ortho-para directed. Because in case of electron releasing nature, we'll have more electron density at ortho and para position. Right? So this group increases electron density at ortho and para position. Hence, we call it as ortho-para directing group. Right? Ortho-para directing groups are activating group also. Okay?
So are there any meta activating?
Yes, no, meta activating we have only one, that is not meta activating. We have deactivating but ortho-para directing halogens. Meta activating we do not have. A little bit, won't be confused over. Let it.
Oh, because it's two positions.
What?
If a nucleophile
was,
that's a nucleophilic ring, then it should attack the...
On meta. Because nucleophilic is negatively charged.
Yeah, yes sir, but then what about the oxygen when the electron pair goes away?
Hmm.
That has a positive charge, so it will be more attached to the
in that case,
charge.
This group should be electron withdrawing. Electron,
okay,
I'm
yeah.
talking about electron releasing group. Correct?
So, but how is oxygen electron releasing?
Because oxygen plus lone pair.
But it's highly electronegative.
That's what. If you draw this structure, this becomes unstable. But if somebody asks you whether this has electron withdrawing nature or releasing nature, it is electron releasing in nature. Because oxygen is more electronegative than this carbon. This sigma bond is shifted towards oxygen atom due to I effect. But this effect is plus M if it is more dominating.
Plus M.
Mesomeric effect.
Wait, sir, so this is plus N?
Plus N.
What's minus?
I'm coming to that.
Okay, so but in this case, the most stable ones are the ones in which there's no charge on any, right? So it's just the ring.
Most stable one is the one which is neutral, actually.
the one where oxygen is not positive.
Not
so
positive.
Will that have the most character?
Huh?
It'll have the most character in that, right?
Then the
this
other one.
Most
then the other one. This one and this one.
Okay.
Okay. Got it? So only one thing you see, RS we have seen how to draw the resonating structure. Two ortho, two meta and one para position. When you have an electron releasing group present on the ring, it is ortho para directing group for an electrophile. Okay? We'll discuss this later also. That's I've given you one thing here. Now about this one, how many RS possible?
Five.
Five RS possible?
Five.
Yes. Five RS possible, and when you draw the RS for this resonating structure, you'll get this negative charge on each carbon atom one by one. The first RS is this. This is a 5 RS you get. Okay? First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Now in all these RS you see, the negative charge is one by one is present on each carbon atom.
Yeah.
Yes? Here first, third, fifth, second, fourth. Okay. So negative charge is equally distributed. The resonance hybrid for this structure is pi electron distributed equally, and each carbon atom will have minus 1 by 5 charge on it. The actual structure. Okay? So this is the resonance hybrid, real structure. And this kind of molecule in which the electron pairs are distributed equally, we call it as aromatic compound. Okay, so this is an aromatic compound.
So will this compound try and, how will it become neutral? Like you can't bond with 4 by 5 electrons.
Why neutral bolna chahiye?
I mean, it's negative, right? So wanting to
move
away.
No,
but negative, but it is stable because it is aromatic compound.
So aromatic has nothing to do with smell.
It is related only with stability of the ion or molecule.
Oh, I thought
it was minus one. Huh? That aroma is different thing. It is aromatic. It's not that popular. It is a factor by which the molecule or ion gets extra stability. Okay?
So what's
1 by 5? 1 by 5 is the charge on each carbon atom. See, this minus 1 charge is distributed among 5 carbon atoms. So one carbon atom will have minus 1 by 5.
So an aromatic molecule will be more stable compared to a non-aromatic.
Yes, obviously. Always. There are aromatic compounds are actually more stable. Most stable, in fact. Okay. We have one more factor here which we call as equal dancing resonance. So in case of dancing resonance, we have the stability overpower the stability of aromatic nature. Only one condition, but that is just an exception. We have, we'll see that.
So that is more stable than aromatic.
Dancing.
So the definition of aromatic is the most stable thing, right?
It is generally, see, the point is, like I said, in resonance, we have only pi electrons and lone pairs are involved. But in dancing resonance, sigma electrons are involved. That is one special kind of resonance. Okay. In that case, the stability is more than the aromatic compound, and that also we have one factor. So I'm not going into that. Okay, we'll discuss that later. But apart from dancing resonance, when the compound is aromatic, it is the most stable compound. Okay, so we'll see the factors affecting stability of compounds or ions, in which we have aromaticity one of the factor, we have non-aromatic one of the factor, anti-aromatic one of the factor, plus M, minus M, plus H, minus H, plus I, minus I. All those factors we have.
So when acids conjugate base is aromatic, then it will become more acidic.
More stable, and it is a very good acid.
It will be more acidic.
Yes, very good acid. Okay, two acid you have. When the conjugate base of one is aromatic, other one is not aromatic. So we can say the previous one, the first one is more acidic than the second. Okay, so this is the second type of conjugated system, that is pi, sigma and lone pair. The third type you write down. The third type of conjugated system is pi sigma and free radical. Pi sigma and free radical. One electron, right? One dot means one single electron. Example of this is CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2 and free radical. Okay? So in this we draw the resonating is like this. So this pi electron, one electron comes over here, it is in half arrow because homolysis it is. One electron is taken up by this carbon, another electron is taken up by this carbon. Okay, and this free radical combines, forms a double bond, and the structure is CH2 radical, CH double bond CH. Got it?
Yes.
How many are is possible here?
Two. So the
right. Three are as possible.
So what is the definition of free radical?
Free radical is any carbon atom which has three bond pair and one unpaired electron. Okay. Unpaired electron, so its number of electron is what? Seven? Seven electrons. But it is not, it is electron deficient, but not, but cannot behave as a Lewis acid, because more than eight electron is not possible. If you have, if you remove this electron also, it becomes carbocation. Right? If you have one electron radical, add one more electron, it becomes a carbonyl. So it is an intermediate which forms during the process of a reaction. Generally, free radical forms in those reactions where we have, we use sunlight, HNU. Okay, then carbon-carbon bonds, homolysis takes place. Homolysis means when you have a carbon-carbon bond, so it has two electron on it. Homolysis and heterolysis, two types of bond cleavage we have, right? So one heterolysis is when the two bond pair is taken up by only one carbon atom, okay? So C negative, C positive, like this, which is in this case not possible because one of the atom must be more electronegative. Like suppose we have carbon and chlorine bond, carbon halogen bond. Chlorine is more electronegative. This bond pair is taken up by this chlorine and it forms C plus a carbocation and Cl minus. Okay, so this is heterolysis. Now when you break this bond, homolysis, one electron is taken up by this carbon, one by this carbon. So this forms a radical like this, carbon-carbon radical. And it is possible when you use sunlight generally. Okay. So free radical is what? Free radical is, it is an intermediate which has three bond pair and one unpaired electron, paramagnetic in nature. Got it?
Yes.
Type 4 we have pi sigma pi. This is type 4. Okay? Alternate pi bond. CH2, double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. Its RS is what? This pi electron comes over here and this pi electron on this carbon. So we get CH2, positive charge, CH double bond, CH2, CH2, negative charge. This is the RS.
So this is going to have a lesser
stability.
Yeah.
In comparison to this? No, if you compare the stability of these two, right? If you compare the stability of these two, this one is
more stable.
Two pi bonds. But while reaction, it won't give reactions with this. The addition takes place this carbon and that carbon. We'll discuss that in alkene chapter. Okay? Reaction of HX on alkene. Okay? It gives conjugated dienes. It is. What is the name of this compound? 1,3 butadiene. 1,3-butadiene. Okay. So 1,3-butadiene gives you 1,4 addition, not 1,2 addition. Reason we'll discuss in alkene. Okay. This is the type 4 system we have. What about this one? In this, do we have resonance possible? Do we have RS possible in this?
Yeah.
So the third one is not possible.
It's not possible. Why?
It's possible.
Pi sigma pi.
So how do you know if something is planar?
All carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized.
So in that one,
no.
So sp2 means
every time.
Sp3.
So it's diagram planar geometry. No, so it will be in the same plane. Carbon 3 bond in the same. Pyramidal is like this. Pyramidal when you put the carbon like this. But in the same plane, diagonal planar. So it is planar. Sorry,
that's type 4.
Type 4, yes.
So should it form another one which has double bond and double?
Where?
Is it that resin? Like, resin with the other structure also should have double bond and double bond.
In this it is not possible. But if you have further conjugation this side, then also it is possible, I suppose.
So this is also still resin.
See, resonating structure you can draw till conjugation is there. Like I effect, what we say, it is distance dependent effect because sigma electrons are involved. Here distance factor is not there, but it requires only conjugation. So in the molecule, we can draw resonating structure till conjugation is there. Like here you see, this part is not in conjugation, sp3 hybridized. So we can draw resonating structure of this one from this carbon to this carbon. This is not involved in resonance, okay? So this resonating structure is what, when you draw it, you'll get a double bond here, negative charge here and positive charge. Okay, for this one if you draw, this pi electron comes over here and this pi electron jumps onto this oxygen. So it is CH2, CH, single bond CO minus, H, double bond and positive charge. Can we draw this way? This pi electron comes over here and this pi electron comes over here. Reverse, this
way. So, how do you know which one becomes positive and which one becomes
positive?
That's what I'm asking. Can we draw this way? This comes over here, this comes over here. You can draw. Draw your name, kya? Draw your name.
Even in the second one.
Yes, that will be a different resonating structure, but that is the least, not stable at all. Because you see, oxygen is more electronegative, so it has tendency to attract electron. That's why the best way to draw the RS is the shifting of electron towards oxygen.
So
not away from.
So even the second one also you can have. Like, the other way
around,
like,
so we can't have positive charge on electronegative atom.
That's what. See, you can draw any structure, whether it is stable or not. That is a different debate. But whether you can draw it or not, you can draw it.
But is it a resonance?
But usually, what we say, usually we'll draw the structure and we shift the electron towards the more electronegative.
Second one, sir. You can have more, right? Double bond, single bond, positive. Yeah. That's all, that's type one, right? We can conjugate that also.
Yeah.
Where?
No, that's Shay, that will go
if
back
you,
to the same.
See,
way.
What you can do, one thing. This comes over here, and this comes over here. This gives you the same.
Sir, can you get this?
Just. What? Arey, jo bhi karna hai kar lo, you'll get this only. Draw karke dekho. See, what you can do, you can shift this here. Okay. So we'll have a double bond here. Okay. And this is positive charge.
Yeah.
This positive negative makes a bond.
Oh.
Carbon, adjacent carbon pe positive negative charge is never stable. Wo ho hi nahi sakta hai. Carbon carbon double bond if you have, you see this. Carbon carbon double bond. If you want to change this structure into this, C single bond, C positive, negative like this. For this, you have to break this pi bond. Correct? And for to break this pi bond, you have to provide a lot of energy. Right? So this is a higher energy molecule or ion. That you can do. It's the same thing. That you can do. No, it's not different. If you draw, if you, let's say, same thing. Understood this?
So is that a resonating structure when minus is on there and plus is on there?
Generally, we don't consider that. But if they ask you to draw, you have to draw. Shifting of electron, you can do, molecule won't do. Molecule to automatic the shifting of electron takes. Listen, we are not, see benzene if you are taking, right? We are trying to study the structure of benzene by shifting the electron. But when benzene exists, the electron is already delocalized in its own way. So when you draw, if you want to draw, you can draw it this way, reverse. But what molecule will do? Oxygen takes electron. So it goes this way. Yes, you can draw, but molecule won't do that. That's why that structure you won't draw. Okay, understood this? Now, apart from this four, these four, there are two more conjugated systems possible, which is not that important. I'll just write down the type. Type 5 and type 6, you write down. Type 5, we have a vacant orbital, P, sigma bond, and a lone pair. Vacant orbital, sigma, and lone pair. Okay? And type 6, we have a lone pair, p orbital lone pair, sigma, and vacant d. Vacant d and lone pair. One example we have already done, BF3.
I don't know,
ask him. It's the same thing. It's lone pair in P orbital. Lone pair in P orbital, sigma bond, vacant D. Okay? Vacant P, sigma bond, lone pair. Example is this. Boron has vacant P orbital, we know this, 3 bond, vacant P. And fluorine has lone pair on it. So, back bonding is possible. This is back bonding.
That's also resonance.
Resonance only. Backbonding is nothing but resonance. Each one of those.
Same thing. So isn't backbonding just a double bond?
No, it's not. It has double bond characteristics. It has pi bond characteristics. Not double bond, pi bond characteristics. Which forms when the sigma bond has been formed. After that, the central atom, if it has vacant orbital, and the other atom has the lone pair, and if size is comparable, then this has tendency to donate electron. That is back bond. Sigma bond form hone ke baad, tendency to donate electron is back bond. Okay? But that BCl3, that bonding is not that strong. Because chlorine may will have 3p orbital. And here we have 2p. 2p, 3p ka overlap is not that great. For bromine also, it is even lesser stable, the bond is. For BF3, the back bonding is strongest. Out of
so, why is this different from vacant orbital?
Where we have vacant orbital?
Like, this is vacant p, but we had another one.
We didn't have the
vacant
p.
Vacant
p. The first one, there was the lone pair.
Yes. Got it? Vacant D, the example is this. We have CH2, lone pair on it, single bond Cl. Right? Chlorine is the element of third period, right? So it has vacant orbital, vacant D orbital. So in this, the resonance is possible. CH2 double bond, Cl, negative, here we have positive. Not that important, but in this case, possible.
So vacant P sigma vacant P will be so vacant P sigma
vacant P. All these are the six different types of conjugated system where the resonance is possible. Now, like I said, the resonating structures or contributors, we have two types of contributors. Okay, so write down next. Contributors or resonating structures. We have two types. One is equal contributor. Other one is unequal contributor. The equal contributor example we have. See, both molecules look like identical, right? This one, equal contributor. Even if you draw the benzene ring, this is also equal contributor. Benzene ring, okay? The stability of RS in case of equal contributors is generally more than the stability of unequal contributors, okay? Stability, will see that comparison, but okay, unequal contributor, the example is CH2 negative C double bond OH. It is a conjugated system.
So in benzene ring, can't you apply pi sigma pi?
You can.
So will it end up to be the same thing as that?
Yes, it should. Neil draw. Okay, and when you shift this here, this becomes negative, this becomes positive. Double bond. Here we are positive, here you are negative. This negative comes over here, this pi electron goes here. Double bond.
But then, positive. What is the one in the middle? You are like positive and negative. Won't that be a separate resonance?
Yeah. Which one? You are talking about this one.
Like one
positive charge,
one negative
charge. Yeah, that one. What
is
this one? Yeah. See, this look like different structures, right? But the positive negative charge here is highly unstable. Okay, and when this comes over here, see, you can take it this way also. We don't draw like this, okay? We just continuously shift this electron pair like this. This comes over here, this comes over here, this comes over here, and we'll get this.
So we just skip that?
Yeah, so we don't write this actually. Okay? So it converts into this, and these two are the resonating structures. So when you draw the hybrid of it, you'll draw the entire molecule.
So benzene has only two resonating structures.
If they ask you how many R is possible for benzene ring, so we'll count all these structures. But this two structure, if you're talking about, I'm talking about this two structure. This two, the contribution of this and this is same in the real structure. So this two are equal contributing structures. Okay, this one, the stability is lesser than this one. Even any charged species is lesser stable than these two structures, right? So their stability is more. But if you talk about the stability of these two, it is same and its contribution is also same.
So which type is that?
This one.
Yeah.
Now here it will be pi sigma lone pair or pi sigma any type you will consider.
So we can start at one type of conjugation and then end up with different types of conjugation.
Yes. In between you can have any kind of conjugation. If it is conjugation, shifting of electrons is possible. Understood this? Now this molecule you see, this comes over here. CH2 double bond CO minus CH3. It is unequal contributor. Okay, the contribution is not same. Even if you take this example, double bond O, this part is not involved in resonance. This part is not involved in resonance. अरे conjugation नहीं है. Simply if you say why.
The first part is
Huh? No, this side, the right side of the molecule is not involved. That's why.
In the first one, why is it first one.
This part is not involved in resonance. We have conjugation only here, not this part. So it is unequal contribution. When when the resonance is there in the entire molecule.
So, but even there, the H bond wasn't it? H is associated with. It's not the parent chain.
Parent chain is this only. Parent chain is this. Got it? Now one thing is, see, like in equal contributor structures, the stability is same, exactly same, and hence the contribution is also same. Right? But here, since the stability is different, so contribution is also different. And that's why it is unequal contributors. So in this case, we can talk about major contributors and major and minor contributors. Major contributors is that structure which is the most stable structure among the resonating structure that you are drawing. Okay? And it contributes maximum into the real structure. Okay? Minor contributors whose stability is less. Okay? And here major and minor is not possible because all RS has the same stability, right? So all are equal contributors.
No.
I'm talking this. If you draw this, it's fine. But these two are equal contributors. Okay. Well, we'll have that. Scale. We'll have 6-7 different rules to find out the stability that we'll do now. Okay. So next, write down. See, like I said here, one of the structure is major contributors and other one is minor contributors, correct? So which one is major or minor, that depends upon the stability of the RS, okay? So to find out the stability of RS, we have 6 or 7 different rules, 8 different rules we have, okay? So according to that rule, we'll find out the stability of RS. And this is the stability of RS comparison of the same molecules or ions. We cannot compare the RS of this and this. Same molecule to RS we are comparing, right? So write down the the factors affecting relative stability of RS resonating structure. Factors affecting the relative stability of RS. Okay. So compare the relative stability of RS in the same manner. Like first we have to apply rule 1, then rule 2 and rule 3, like this we have. Okay? So rule 1 in this you write down. Rule 1 you write down. The structure which has more number of pi bonds is more stable. The structure which has more number of pi bond is more stable. Okay, so first example in this, suppose the molecule is this. Okay. Can you draw the RS in this? Correct? Okay. Can you draw RS in this one? Suppose this is A and this is B. Which one is more stable, A or B?
A.
Because it has more number of pi. So stability of A is more than that of B. Okay? What is the RS for this one? This comes over here. Okay. Second one has more number of pi bonds. So B is more stable than B. Okay. Just you have to follow the rules in this. First rule, if fails, then we use the second rule, third rule, and so on. Okay. Now the property of this is what? Suppose you have to draw the RS of this two molecule. Okay. So the RS kya hoga? Will have a structure like this. Single bond O, and this pi bond is delocalized from this carbon to this oxygen to this carbon, right? So we'll have a pi bond characteristics here, like this. Okay, pi bond characteristics here. Now, which one is more stable here? A is more stable. So if the question is the bond order of this C1 C2 carbon, if you want to compare the bond order of C1 C2 carbon, so we can definitely say that the bond order of C1 C2 carbon is closer to 2, since this is more stable. So this contributes more into the real structure, right? So it is closer to 2, and we can say the bond order of C1, C2 carbon lies in this range. This we can say. And if they ask the question for equal contributors, remember we cannot find out the exact value of bond order. We can give this range. Okay, then option also will be in range only, whether it is closer to 1 or closer to 2. Got it? First of all, the bond order here is what? 1? Here it is 2. So it lies in this range 1 to 2. And since this one is more stable, which has bond order 2, right? So we can say that bond order is closer to 2. So it must be more than 1.5, but less than 2. Because if both are equal, then bond order is what? 1.5, average of the 2. Right? So since it is not equal, so this is more stable, so closer to 2. Yes, we can see. Understood this? Rule number 2 you write down. And remember always, from these rules we'll compare the relative stability of RS of a given molecule or ion. We cannot compare the RS of the two different molecules. C is this C1, C2 bond order. C1, C2 bond order. Carbon 1, 2. Okay? We'll do this bond order part also later on. Okay? I'm just giving you an idea. Rule number 2 you write down. When the number of pi bonds are equal, then stability decreases with charge separation. Charge separation means when you have one molecule is charged, another one is neutral. So neutral one is more stable in the other way we can say. So for this, the example is, you see this one. Benzene pay will have OH, like this. Again? And its RS is what? We have done this already. This comes over here and this comes over here. So its resonating structure is OH positive. This one. Another example, if you see, NH2 nitrogen has one lone pair. It is also electron releasing. Okay? This electron pair comes over here, this pi electron shift onto this carbon. Now in these two examples, if you compare, how many pi bonds we have here? 3. How many pi bonds we have here? 3. So first rule we cannot compare. Then we'll have a charge separation here in this, plus minus. Here it is, no charge, right? So this one is more stable. A is more stable than B. Got it? Similarly in second one, again A is more stable than B. There's no charge separation.
Wait, so by charge separation you mean like presence of charge?
Yes, charge presence.
Because that in the next
overall it is neutral.
Yeah, so in like the next resonating structure of that, the minus moves one more down.
Yes, right? Yes.
So both of those we cannot compare using the second.
With this rule we cannot compare. Okay. For that we have another. Okay. Next time, rule number 3.
which is the actual physical distance between the charges doesn't matter.
That is also a factor. We'll see that. Another rules we have.
But that's not this one.
No. Like, if you want to compare from rule 1 and rule 2, another RS if you draw. These two structure we cannot compare with rule 1 and 2. For that we have other rule. Okay? Next, rule number 3. Charge separation is just on the presence of charge. Charge presence, that's what. Rule number 3, write down. When the molecule has equal number of pi bonds, when the molecule has equal number of pi bonds and charge separation, equal charge separation and equal number of pi bonds, then stability is directly proportional to the number of atoms having complete octet. Number of atoms having complete octet. Example, you write down BH2 in this resonating structure, RS is possible? Resonance in this is possible?
Yeah.
No, it's possible?
Yeah.
Okay. So when you draw the RS of this, pi sigma vacant B, right? Boron has vacant B. This comes over here. BH2 double bond. CH single bond CH. Okay, here we have the negative charge. Now when you look at these two structures, okay, how many pi bonds in the two structure we have? One. What is the charge separation? One negative charge. So we cannot do this from the first and second rule. Correct? Now this boron has how many electrons? 6 electrons. Carbon has 8, chlorine has more than 8, right? It has expanded octet. Now this chlorine has 8, carbon has 8, even boron has 8 electrons if you go. Right, so all three atoms has complete octet here. That's why the B is what? B is more stable than A. Okay, so if charge separation is same, number of pi bond is same, we'll count the atoms as complete octet. That's what we see.
So what if in like we have like a molecule where in one resonating structure oxygen doesn't have a complete octet, in the other carbon doesn't? Like if you have two different atoms with incomplete octets, then how will you choose?
See, we cannot see like this. If you can give me the structure, then I can tell you. Because we'll see the number of pi bonds first, charge separation, then we'll see this rule, we'll see the other factors also, whether the compound is aromatic or not. There are many things, like you cannot say aisa aisa hoga to kya hoga. Dekhna padega aisa aisa kaisa hai. Samajh rahe ho?
So, but the given list that you gave, that's in the like
order.
Decreasing order.
Decreasing order. Mostly when you do some practice, you will understand what rule you have to apply. So like you are saying, so we have rules for that. We'll follow that rule. Rule 1, rule 2, rule 3.
So we always have to go in order.
Yes. Apart from one or two rules, like in case of ring or aromatic compound, we'll see that in the last. But mostly for first 4-5 rules, we'll follow the same order. Okay? Rule number, one more example we'll see.
So
how does boron only ion?
Only you.
So what is
this? Same exact
thing. Tell me in this one, which one is more stable? A or B? So B is one. B is more simple, right?
1 by 1.
Directly we can say B. Or if you apply rule, this rule also. This carbon does not have octet here, but this carbon has octet, right? And that is why B is also more stable.
So, but then in the first one, oxygen has completed.
Huh?
Hey,
here also has completed. Yeah, okay. Next one, rule number. What is rule number? 4 or 5? 4, write down. Write down. If the first 3 rule fails, huh? This carbon has 6 electrons here. 2 bond and 1 hydrogen. 6 electrons. This carbon has 8 electrons. So complete octet. And that is true for oxygen also here. Okay? That's why second one is more stable. Write down. If the first 3 rules fails, then the negative charge is more stable on more electronegative atom, and the positive charge is more stable on. Abhi class hai Ravi?
Haan.
Okay. Build up.
Haan.
More stable on less electronegative. Haan. Less electronegative element. Okay. So, example kya tha?
Sir, or more electropositive.
Yeah. Negative charge, more electronegative. More electropositive you can say. And positive charge, less electronegative or more electropositive. Okay? For example, you see this. Correct? Which one? Can you draw RS into this one? Draw the RS of this.
So this is the
fourth.
Yeah.
It is. Yeah.
This is the fourth.
No, it is.
So, sir, my fail will mean that the rest of the rules are the same. The rest of the 3 rules before that are the same.
Yes.
Everything else is the
same. You see the number of icons same, charge is also same. Octet is also fine here.
So, first
one
is more stable.
First one is more stable. Why? Because of charge on more electronegative. A is more stable than B. This one, can you draw the RS for this? 3. One is this. One we can draw with this. Another one is what? Okay. So this one is A, B, and C. Which one is most stable?
Second one.
Because oxygen has negative charge. B is most stable.
Yeah, but third one carbon also has
hydrogen. Relative it is. Oxygen and nitrogen. Here we have Oxygen and carbon then.
Yeah.
Then nitrogen and carbon.
So that is more
like
it.
So
B
and then
C. Is it right? So
first
is
charge.
First
one is more.
B and oxygen. First table is the next charge or more.
Not required. Okay. One more example.
So, but there will be a mode where it's single bond O and double bond C, double bond N.
Yes.
So, it's AC, man. So, is it?
A is most stable.
Yeah, AC.
Then C and then B. Oxygen, nitrogen, and carbon, the electronegativity order. Order of stability is A maximum.
Only two.
Right on, rule number 5.
How many rules are there?
8.
So it should be more stable than A and B.
Which one?
It's C.
C. No, here also we have 3 pi bonds. 2 plus 1, 3.
2 plus 1.
2. 1 triple bond has 2 pi bonds.
C
two five ones and one there. Three. Okay. Next rule number five you write down. Stability will be more when the opposite charge is. Stability will be more when the opposite charges are closer and the like charges are far apart. You can take the example of phenol. Okay, you can draw structures. This one you see. Okay, A, B, C, which one is most stable? ABC again. Neutral, closer. ABC the order. Same order. Next, rule write down. Rule number 6.
So isn't this a benzene in which it's detached to center also? Some resonance structure where the center to center is connected and double bond
around it. That is, we have one rule that price. We'll discuss. Right on next. Stability of carbocation, that is plus I effect. Carbocation increases when it is surrounded to. Stability of carbocation increases when it is surrounded to more number of alkyl group.
Oh, sir, is that the primary tertiary?
Yes, it's the same. RS will be what? This comes over here. RS, pi sigma, positive charge, type 1. Okay? And it gives you this. Which one is more stable?
This first one.
First one, because it is 3 degree.
1 degree.
First one is more stable. Right? And it is exactly opposite to the negative charge is there. Which one is more stable? Negative charge. It's RS is, this comes over here, and this comes on this card. First one, because it is 3 degree, and this is 2D, right? So this is more stable, carbon ion. Next right on. Rule number 7. Rule number 7. The structure which has
that one has the other one.
The structure which has more benzenoid form is more stable. The structure which has more benzenoid form is more stable.
Benzenoid
form is more stable. This rule we call it as Fry's rule. Fry's rule. More benzenoid form, more stable. Okay.
All these rules need to be followed in order.
No, this is not in the order. It is different. This is for cyclic aromatic compound engineer. Okay. Till rule number 6. 6 it is in the order.
So, but then the
This is for a specific compound when you have cyclic ring like this. This is one structure, and when you draw the resonating structure of this, you will get. Okay, so in this, A is more stable than B. Why? Because A has two benzenoid form. You see, this is a benzene ring, this is also a benzene ring. Okay, this pi bond is shared by the two rings. So there's two benzene ring, you can see, so A is more stable than B, more benzenoid form. So it has two benzenoid form here. Second one, we have only one, you see. Here we have one and two benzenoid form. Okay? This molecule we call it as naphthalene.
So they share two.
Wait, how did the second
one share two bonds?
So why is the first one more stable?
One?
Yeah.
And two benzenoid. This pi bond is shared with the two rings.
Okay.
One and two.
Yeah.
Here we have only one. This is not a benzene ring.
So first one.
This molecule anthracene.
So you cannot have more than two, right? Two benzene.
Yes. Other structure also possible.
Okay.
In this we cannot have. A is more than B. Last rule write down. Aromaticity. Aromatic compound is the most stable. Then we have non-aromatic, anti-aromatic.
So what is anti-aromatic?
Okay. A.
Okay, thank you.
So it's non-ad.
See, this aromaticity we'll discuss separately, okay? I'll just discuss one thing here. Molecules, you have to compare the stability of RS. Okay, aromatic compounds are those compounds.
4N plus C.
Which are conjugated, cyclic, planar, and has 4N plus 2 pi electrons. Where n is equals to any number 0, 1, 2 and so on. Okay? If this condition is satisfied, then the compound is aromatic. Conjugated, cyclic, planar, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Anti-aromatic, all conditions are true, but it should have 4n pi electrons. N is equals to 0, 1, 2 and so on.
So all pi bonds.
First one is, see, here we have three pi bond, correct? Here we have two and this is two. But again, this rule one we won't apply here. Because if this compound, if you see how many pi electrons it has, one, two, three, four, and lone pair we also counted pi bond because it can form a pi bond here, right? So one, two, and six. So it has six pi electrons. For this one, it is one, 2, 3, 4. 4 pi electrons. Okay? So obviously this one is aromatic compound. Right? For n is equals to 1, it is aromatic. For n is equals to 1, it is anti-aromatic. And this one is non-aromatic compound.
So we don't count the...
No, it's only for ring. Cyclic. Conjugated cyclic plane. It's only for cyclic compounds. Non-aromatic related, we will discuss in aromaticity separately. Okay, we'll discuss that. Okay. Aromaticity, we again discuss. Okay, separately we'll discuss this. But obviously, this one is aromatic, this one is anti-aromatic, and this one is non-aromatic. Okay. Usually, the compounds generally. It's not non-aromatic, but the stability of non-aromatic compounds and the normal compounds is almost similar. Okay, aromaticity gives extra stability to the molecule at normal condition. Anti-aromaticity is unstable. It is unstable molecule at normal condition, right? So obviously this one is most stable and this one is least stable because the order is this: aromatic, non-aromatic, and anti-aromatic.
So when you apply this rule and then
when you solve some questions and you look at the molecules, you'll understand this molecule is aromatic. So it's all about practice. Like I said, the first molecule is three. See, when aromaticity is there, it dominates all other factors. So aromatic compounds, always you have to consider the most stable compound, except dancing resonance that we'll discuss later, which is just a one case. But in general, aromatic compounds are most stable. So whenever the compound is aromatic, you have to take that compound as the most stable.
So this is not one. As in, if you have to start,
yeah, exactly.
No. Rule 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, you can consider in an order. But 7th and 8th one is simply different. benzenoid form. You'll understand when you look at the structure like this. You can understand that this is the benzenoid form rule you
so
have to apply.
So, if I see rule 7 or 8 saying something, I shouldn't consider the others.
No. This and this will, you know, dominate the all of them.
And what if 7 and 8 contradict each other?
No, when you have aromaticity, it's always more simple. Aromaticity overpowers everything, dominates everything.
So what about in the other factors, what are the order?
One, rule 1 to 6 is in the order. Till 5 it's in the order. 6 one is that one, no, carbocation stability, plus I minus I. So that is again different. Okay, but 1 to 5 is in order. When you solve some question, you'll understand what rule you have to apply. There's no doubt in that. So don't get worried about that. Okay. So aromaticity, this rule will be applied when we have cyclic compounds like this, where you can have the, you know, possibility of aromatic compound. Aromatic compound is only possible for cyclic system. Open chain hai toh rules 7 and 8 you cannot apply. Right. Okay. This order they have asked many times in the exam. Need with the bahut bar pucha hai order. Currently, aromatic, non-aromatic, anti-aromatic. Okay. Many times they have asked this order. Aromaticity, like I said, we'll discuss this separately also. What are the conditions? Like this rule, we call it as the molecule which has this electron. This rule we call it as Huckel's rule. It is Huckel's rule. 4n plus 2 pi electron, Huckel's rule. There are other molecules which does not follow Huckel's rule, but is still aromatic. Okay, so all those things we'll discuss separately in aromaticity. Okay, so this is the, you know, rules we have to follow to find out the stability of resonating structure. Okay, now to find out the bond order, like I said, okay, bond order depends upon the stability of resonating structure. The RS which is more stable contributes more, and according to that we'll have the range of bond order. Okay. So bond order, we have already discussed in chemical bonding that it has fractional as well as integral value also. Both bond order possible. Yeah, no, MOT mein.
Yes.
Molecular order. So if the fractional bond order possible in the molecule which has resonance. In the molecule which has resonance.
Sir, you're supposed to ask for a break.
Only
recorded. He's under pressure, he can't think anything. Okay, we'll take a break. Application of resonance will start. Entire organic chemistry based on that.
I think you break one more time.